Hello children, today we are going to learn about the chapter
Who Did Patrick's Homework, which is written by Carol Murray. This is a wonderful story which has presented magical realism, which means something is that is not magic that but a belief in a beautiful manner. A boy named Patrick who gets inspired and feels propelled to work hard by an imaginary elf, a supernatural being. He is not only able to complete his work, rather scores high grades. This story conveys the message that self-help works wonders. Because if we are doing self-help, we can create wonders.
So, we'll know the story further. So, let us read the story. Patrick never did homework. Too boring, he said.
He always said that homework is very much boring. He played basketball and baseball and Nintendo instead. Nintendo is a computer game. His teachers always told him, Patrick, do your homework or you won't learn a thing. Yes, children, it's very true. Whenever we are doing our homework, we are learning the things and the things get clarified easily if we do our homework. And it's true, sometimes he did feel like a ding-a-ling, but what could he do? He hated homework. So he felt like an ignoramus child because he hated homework. He never did his homework. Then on St. Patrick's Day, his cat was playing with a little doll and he grabbed it away. To his surprise, it wasn't a doll at all, but a man of the tiniest size. So one day when Patrick has seen his doll was playing with a his cat was playing with a doll, but it was not actually a doll. It was a man of the tiniest size. He had a little wool shirt with old-fashioned breeches and a high tall that much like a witch. He yelled, save me, don't give me back to that cat. I will grant you a wish, I promise you that. Now elf is asking help from the Patrick as he was grabbed by the cat and he wanted Patrick to help him, and on the contrary, he will fulfill his wish. Patrick couldn't believe how lucky he was. That was the answer to all of his problems. So he said, only if you do all my homework till the end of the semester, that's 35 days. If you do a good enough job, I could even get A's. So now here Patrick is putting a wish towards the elf that he will do his homework for 35 days till the semester ends so that he could get A's. The little man's face wrinkled like a dish cloth thrown in the hamper. He kicked his legs and doubled his fist and he grimaced and scowled and pursed his lips. He's showing his anger that he didn't want to do his homework, but he has no choice. Now he is saying, oh, am I cursed? But I will do it. But he is saying that he is feeling cursed, but he has to do the homework. And true to his word, that little elf began to do Patrick's homework. Except there was one glitch. The elf didn't always know what to do and he needed help. And he always say, help, Patrick, help me, help me. He would say, and Patrick would have to help him. In whatever way. I don't know this word, the elf squeaked while reading Patrick's homework. Get me a dictionary, know what's even better, look up the word and sound it out by each letter. So every time elf needed help of Patrick and he insisted Patrick to help him. When it came to math, Patrick was out of luck. What are timetables? The elf shrieked. We elves never need that. And addition and subtraction and division and fractions. Here, sit down beside me. You simply must guide me. Now again, he is facing problem in maths that he didn't know. He didn't know anything about maths, addition, subtraction. Elves know nothing of human history. To them, it's a mystery. Again, elf is having problem in history also. And he is asking Patrick to help him. So the little elf, already a shouter, just got louder. Go to the library. I need books. More and more books. And you can help me read them too. Now he is telling Patrick to bring the books from the library so he can refer to those books and can help him. As a matter of fact, every day in every way, that little elf was a nag. He was always shouting that Patrick, help me. Patrick was working harder than ever and was at a drag. He was staying up nights, had never felt so weary, so tired, was going to school with his eyes puffed and bleary. Finally, the last day of school arrived and the elf was free to go. As for homework, there was no more. So he quietly and slyly slipped out the back door, slyly, secretly. So he has finished his homework and now the elf wanted to leave the place and he secretly moved out
the back from the back door.
Patrick got his A's. His classmates were amazed. His teachers smiled and were full of praise. They were surprised that how Patrick has got the A's because he never did his homework. But they were feeling very happy that he has got A's. And his parents, they wondered what had happened to Patrick. He was now the model kid. Cleaned his room and did his chores, was cheerful, never rude-like. He had developed a whole new attitude. Now his parents also wondered that Patrick had become a new child, a new kid who is always disciplined, who always willing to do his work, who has not only good in studies now, but he is also taking good care of his responsibilities, taking good care of his room also. You see, in the end, Patrick still thought, help made that tiny man to do all his homework. But I'll share a secret just between you and me. It wasn't the elf. Patrick had done it himself. Absolutely true. It was Patrick only who has done his homework. It was not the elf, because every time Patrick was on his toes and he was helping. He was bringing books from the library and he was referring the books. He was waking up day and night to help elf. So it was Patrick only who has done his homework. I hope the chapter is clear to you all. Thank you, children.